So today, we'll use grid and map function to work on our services. First, let's create a new component. So open your text editor, open components, and here, add a new file, services.js. We'll create a functional component. So add export default function and the component name. I would say app services. In return, let's just add a div tag with a text services. Now let's import this component under app.js. On top, import app services. Then at the bottom, after app about, let's add app services element. Let's check the preview and we can see services. It means our component is working. We will now add this title, subtitle and the content. For this content, we need a grid system. So open React Bootstrap, click components, layout and grid. We'll use the Fluid container. So copy the import of container, row and call. You can add them under services.js. Then copy this container element. You can then remove this div tag and instead add the section. Add the ID services and a class called block and services block. Inside this section, you can paste the container element. For the title, just after the container, add a div tag with a class title holder. Use S2 tag for the title, our services. For the subtitle, add another div tag with a class subtitle. Let's copy the subtitle from the website and add them over here. Let's check the preview and now we can see our title and a subtitle. Now let's work on this content, which has icon, title and a description. So inside this call element, let's add a div tag for the icon. So let's also use the class called icon. For the title, let's use the h3 tag. And for the description, let's use the p tag. Since our content has got 3 columns, we will be using sm with a grid value of 4. And since we have a custom style, we will be using a class holder. These are the static content, but I want to use a dynamic one. So on top, I will just paste my services data. It has got properties like ID, icon, title, and description. So if you want to use this data, after this row, you can use the map function. So you can add services data.map. We can then access services. Then inside this return, we can just add this call element. Now, to access the title, we can use services.title. Likewise, to access the description, we can use services.description. For the icon, we have to grab the HTML. So let's use developer tool. And let's get the HTML for the icon. And where it says class, let's try to access from services.icon. In call element, let's also add the key attribute and add services.id. Finally, before checking the preview, let's change this to class name. Once done, check the preview. And now we can see the content in our services. If you compare it with the design, it is looking exactly the same. Great. This is the end of this session. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. Thank you.